Greetings, friends. David Marks here. The latest version of Adobe Photoshop Lightroom Classic has just been released, and it includes some neat new features. In this video, I'm going to walk you through how to upgrade to the latest version, the 12th version of Adobe Photoshop Lightroom Classic. With a little guidance, I think that you'll find the whole upgrade process pretty easy, but there are some pitfalls out there. So please be careful and take your time if you're playing along. Before we jump into a step-by-step review of the upgrade process, I need to point out two important details. First, to run Adobe Photoshop Classic version 12, your computer must meet Adobe's updated system requirements. For Mac users, this means that your computer must be running OS X 11, which Apple calls Big Sur, or something more recent, like Monterey or Ventura. If your Mac is using an older operating system, if you're still using something like OS X 10.15, then you either need to upgrade your operating system first, or you need to stick with an older version of Lightroom Classic. In addition, Lightroom Classic version 12 requires a graphics card with at least 2 GB of video RAM and metal support. For Windows users, your computer must be using the Windows 10 version 20H2 operating system or something more recent to install this upgrade. Second, I'm going to assume that you already have an up-to-date backup of your current Lightroom catalog and of all your images before you begin the Lightroom Classic version 12 upgrade process. If you do not have an up-to-date backup, then please stop now and take care of this critical step. If you need more advice on how to back up all of your images and your catalog, then please follow one of my in-depth tutorials on that critical topic before you install this upgrade. With those warnings out of the way, let's start with a quick peek inside of my existing Lightroom catalog. What we need to know is the name of your current Lightroom catalog and exactly where your index, your .lrcat file, lives inside of your computer. The easiest way to find this information out is to go up to the word Lightroom on the menu bar at the top of the screen on a Mac, and then down to the Catalog Settings option. Windows users, you will find the exact same button, this Catalog Settings button, at the bottom of the Edit menu. Once you've opened up the Catalog Settings menu, click on the General tab. In this block, Lightroom Classic displays the exact file path through your computer to this catalog. This section right here is like a map to the lrcat database file that you are currently using. We're going to ask Classic to show us where this file lives in just a second, but this info, the path to your current catalog, and its exact name are critical, so please write this stuff down if needed. To reveal the location of your current catalog, click on the Show in Finder button on a Mac, or the Show in Explorer button on a PC. When you tap on this button, an operating system window will appear. I strongly suggest that you move this window off to the side of your screen, but don't close it. Next, you can click back into Classic, and you can close out of the Catalog Settings box. Once you know the name and the file path that you must follow to find this catalog, then you need to quit or completely exit out of Classic. Okay, so to install the Lightroom Classic version 12 upgrade, you need to open up the Adobe Creative Cloud app. On a Mac, you can probably find this cloud icon up here near the top right corner of your screen. PC folks, you should be able to find the same icon somewhere near the bottom right corner on your screen on the Windows Quick Launch bar. If you can't find this icon in either place, then first, make sure that you're connected to the internet, and then look for the Adobe Creative Cloud app here inside of your computer's Applications or Programs folder. Once you are inside of the Adobe Creative Cloud app, we need to make sure that you're signed in to your Creative Cloud account. Since I'm already signed in, the next step is to click here where it says Updates. In here, tap on the Check for Updates button, and once your screen looks like this, tap here to start the Lightroom Classic version 12 upgrade process. At this point, the latest version of Lightroom Classic will download and install in the background. While the new software is downloading, let me remind you that each version of Lightroom Classic uses a different catalog format. Installing the program itself, what's going on right now where it says updating, is only the first step in the total process. Once your new software has been installed, then we will also need to upgrade that .lrcat file that we tracked down a minute ago. If you only have one Lightroom catalog, then this step, the catalog upgrade step, which will start in just a minute, is something that you'll only need to do once, and life is easy. If, for some reason, you've decided to add extra complexity into your life by working with multiple Lightroom catalogs, then you'll need to repeat the catalog upgrade step again and again for each of your classic catalogs. Now that the program has been upgraded, we can click back into the Creative Cloud App Manager, and then we can tap on the Open button beside the words Lightroom Classic V12. At this point, you should see a box asking you to confirm that this is indeed the catalog that you want to upgrade. Take a moment here, please, to carefully read the screen and make sure that the catalog that you are about to change is indeed the one that we tracked down at the start of this video. Assuming that Lightroom Classic has found the right catalog, then this window will also show us something else that's important. Do you see this part down here where it says -V12? After a decade of despair, Adobe is trying to make it clear that when you upgrade from one version of Classic to another, that your Lightroom catalog is automatically going to be duplicated and renamed. What they are trying to tell you is that your new catalog and all of its helper monkey files, they'll all have this -V12 added on to the end of their file names. Now, I don't think that adding -V12 is a great help, but I'm pleased that Adobe is finally trying to make it clear that your new .lrcat file will not be compatible with older versions of Lightroom Classic. Since the addition of that -V12 tag is good enough for now, I'm going to hit the upgrade button. This step might take a while, so please be patient, especially if you have a large catalog with thousands of images. Since I'm only using a little demo catalog today, that went pretty fast. But again, if you have hundreds or thousands of photos, your catalog upgrade process might take a bit longer. Do you remember that window that I told you to set aside at the beginning of this tutorial? Well, if you look in that window now, you can see some of what the upgrade process actually did. In this folder, there are now two .lrcat files. In this folder, there's my old file. This is the one I was using before the upgrade. This is my Lightroom version 11 file. And here's the new one, the copy that the upgrade just made for version 12. If everything worked as expected at this point, then you are all set. If everything worked properly, you could stop at this point and start playing with version 12's new features. The steps that I'm about to show next are not mandatory, but I find these two little tricks very helpful. First, I want to delete a couple of small extraneous files, a couple of minor little things that the upgrade process left behind. If it helps, please tell your operating system to show you a list of all the files that live in this folder, and be sure that it also shows you their complete file name and the extension. My old catalog, the lrcat file here, the one that I was using before today's upgrade. This old file, it can cause a lot of confusion. So let me explain why Adobe did this. Adobe intentionally left my old .lrcat file untouched for two reasons. They left this file alone so that if something were to go terribly wrong, you could try the whole upgrade process all over again. Second, they left this file completely unchanged because Lightroom Classic catalogs are not backwards compatible. I can't think of any reason why you would want to downgrade and go back to Lightroom Classic version 11. But if for some reason you needed to make that choice, then we would absolutely need this file. It seems unlikely to me that you would downgrade, but just in case, let's add the -V11 suffix to this catalog's name if it doesn't already have it, and then we'll tuck it away. To do that, I'm going to rename this file and append V11. Next, I'm going to move this old catalog somewhere safe. In my case, I'm going to move it into this backups folder so that it doesn't confuse me and so that I'll know where I can find it if I need it at some point in the future. Next, I'm going to delete 2 leftover helper files. If you're playing along, be sure that you only delete this old helper.lr data and this old .lrcat-data files. Be sure that you do not accidentally delete anything that has the new -v12 tag added onto the end of its file name. Finally, I'm going to double click on my .lrcat, the one with the v12 added to it, file name to relaunch the program. Once Classic loads, the very last step in the upgrade process is to go into the Preferences menu. On a Mac, the Preferences menu lives here under the words Lightroom Classic. On a PC, this button lives near the bottom of the Edit menu. Once the Preferences menu opens, let's jump over to the General tab, the very first tab on the left. And here, where it says Startup, let's make sure that the catalog that we just upgraded, the one with the -v12 at the end of its file name, is now the startup default. If you take the time to do this step, then this catalog should open automatically whenever you launch the new program. If you need more help controlling which catalog launches, then I have a separate tutorial elsewhere on some additional tricks you can use to ensure that you're in the right place every time. That lesson, though, and more, are not essential steps in the V12 upgrade process. Well, there you go. At this point, the Lightroom Classic version 12 upgrade is complete, and now you're ready to jump into some of my other tutorials on the exciting new features that Adobe has given us. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in our next tutorial.